Do you remember that little jumper gown that I bought? The one with the pink polka dots? Well, I laid it out on the bed last week and I put it over my shoulder and I held it tight, pretending my baby was in it, and I danced around the room. If anyone would have seen me, they would have thought I was crazy for sure.
Not me.
Jason, do you believe in heaven? That somewhere there's a God looking down on us?
Yes, I do.
What about proof?
When I stand by the ocean looking out to the horizon, I can't explain it. I just feel like I'm part of something, you know, bigger than myself. And that's all the proof I need.
For me, it's the stars. Just looking up in the sky and feeling small and important. Same time, scared, yet happy to be a part of it. Do you think there are stars in heaven?
I think there's everything you want for the baby. Love, no security, happiness.
Christina, I don't want you near Sam.
Jason,
how many times do I have to tell
you? Alexis saved my life.
We were able to treat Sam before hypothermia set in. Now, Sam, I've advised you to stay in bed in the past. This time, it's an order.
Thanks.
I'll leave you to it.
Sam, what was doing on the roof?
I was lying here, thinking about what you said about the baby having stars in heaven, and I just wanted to see them. Jason, I wanted to connect with my child and imagine that she was a part of something.
Sam, but you should have waited for me. The doctor said how weak you are.
I know. It was stupid of me. I'm sorry.
I didn't say it was stupid.
I just needed to believe that her soul was in heaven. She didn't just end. The stars. And it started to snow and I felt cold and empty and I just waited. I waited and then I got a collapse.
What'd you feel?
Peace. Because I need it. Jason, I need it. So bad.
You must be glad to be going home.
I'm not glad about much of anything these days.
I'm really sorry. I didn't mean that, though. Whole foot and mouth thing you do a lot.
It's okay. Listen,
Sam, I don't know if this is going to help, but a while ago, I suffered a miscarriage. The pain is unspeakable, but it does lessen over time. And believe it or not, one day you'll just wake up and notice the sun is still shining.
You ready to go?
She was just released.
Why didn't you call me?
Because you're not responsible for me anymore, Jason.
Sam, I never was, but I still want to be the one to take you home.
Where are my baby's things?
In the nursery. I didn't know what to do with them. You know, at first I thought I would just throw everything away or give everything away and then paint the room so there would be no sign of her when you came home, but then I realized that, you know, maybe you needed to see the things again and then decide for yourself.
Okay. It's good because I want to see them.
Sam, wait.
Fuss over me, please.
I'm not. In fact, I gotta go out. There's a lot going on with Sonny and the business.
Are you okay?
Yeah, so far. Sonny is in some serious trouble and I gotta do what I can to help him.
Okay, good, go. I mean,
you sure?
I understand.
Are you sure? Because I can have Emily come over and...
No, Jason, no, please. I need to be alone right now.
I'm not telling you what to do, but, you know, for what it's worth, I went into a room, and it's hard. You know, I don't usually care about things, clothes, but walking into that nursery and seeing, you know, the toys you picked out, don't rush, okay? Don't push yourself before you're ready.